from one Chery Sour to another, and we're giving those folk at Pentridge a little rest, as today we're going old school with a brew inspired by the much beloved Penny Sweet, the Fizzy Chery Cola bottle, and the first in their Retro Sweet Shoppe mini series. We welcome back to the channel Brew York. Starting out life back in 2016, their tale is an oh too common one. Two dedicated home brewers, Wayne Smith and Lee Grabham, having tasted some success at some home brewing competitions, made the dream a reality by ditching the day jobs and going all in, opening their doors right in the city centre with the challenge of balancing both traditional styles and the emerging new ones. As they themselves put it, we couldn't ignore the fact that we're in the heart of a very traditional city that predominantly drinks cask. So definitely playing to the room early on. But they also would add, if we really got to do exactly what we wanted, it would have been keg from day one, as they're the beers we like to drink ourselves. But in time, they sure have branched away from those good old traditional days, concocting all manner of wild and woolly concoctions. And we're hoping today's is no exception. And in fact, the same could be said for the rest of this Sweet Shoppe series, which, as a big old kid myself, I am eagerly keeping an eye out for. But as for today, we have a tangy sour base backed up with sweet chery to maintain some juiciness and that distinct fizz from the classic sweet. So let's get our weighing scales out. Let's get pouring. So if not for that big old slightly pinky head, it almost looks like a Coke. And it does have that sweet chery tang on the nose. There is that real sweetness of chery in there too. It really does smell like sticking your nose into a bag of the classic sweet themselves. So it's actually not as tart as you think it might well be. It goes to grab you right up top, but it fades into a real sugary sweetness. And it is a real dark chery flavour, bordering on almost plum-like, with just a very subtle medicinal note right in behind. But I tell you what, as an accurate representation of those old sweets, boy, it does one hell of a job. I could eat me a good couple of bags of those, and could drink me a good couple of cans of these. And at only 4.5% ABV, you'd be doing very little damage too. In fact, the only real sign that they haven't just blended a good couple of pounds worth of them is this subtle maltiness in the finish. It's bready, almost biscuity even, but of course, oh so sweet. And as for this mini series they're working on, boy, if the rest are as good as this, I am gonna be one happy camper. And now we're well down into the beer, it has remained super solid and super consistent throughout. A little of that early tang has subsided some, and as the carbonation has died away, it feels just a little heavier in the mouth. That aside, it has remained a sugary treat to behold and enjoy. I'm just a little annoyed I didn't buy a few more.